This video series is part of the Aquacosm Plus initiative to adopt open science practices and bridge the barriers to open mesocosm science. In this video, we are going to talk about metadata. Metadata are data that provide information about your data. They are the description of your data. So the answer to the question of who collected the data, when, where, how, and why. In the context of a mesocosm experiment, this can be translated into the PI and the affiliation of your group, the time and place of the experiment, the methodology you use to collect and process the samples, and your hypothesis. So, why do we need metadata? One of the main practices of open science is to follow the FAIR data principles, which allow the data to be both human and machine readable. By providing rich metadata, you enable your dataset to be easily searchable and thus findable. Also, having answered to the previous questions helps understanding the context of the data and increase their probability to being reused by someone else. To put that in perspective, let's take an example dataset from an old mesocosm experiment. Here, mesocosm received single and repeated additions of Sahara dust. If you wanted to use this dataset, you are lacking important information about the experiment itself, like how much dust was added and how often. Also, you don't know how the samples were collected, and most importantly, you don't know what method was used to estimate the primary and bacterial production. Lacking this information, you have no way of understanding and interpreting the data, so you cannot reuse them. On the other hand, if you had this important information about this dataset, so its metadata, you would be able to use it in whatever way you see fit. This is why we ask you to provide metadata for mesocosm experiment, so that you can share your dataset and increase your overall productivity. In the next video, we are going to talk about how to provide metadata through the mesocosm metadata catalog.